next day was about to be Khardungla with Nubra and Hunder and Diskit. The ride till Khardungla was quite amazing. As I said, passes are like 10 kilometers before the pass and 10 kilometers after the pass. You will not be getting anything but loose gravel or grit or dust, basically. But at Khardungla, you can expect the kind of weather I was riding in. As you can see,
close till I get up. Time is barely on our side. I don't wanna waste what's left. The storms we chase are leading us, and love is all we'll ever trust. Yeah, no, I don't wanna waste what's left. And on we'll go through the wastelands, through the highways, till my shadow turns to sun rays. And I...
Khardungla, I was descending towards North Pulu. I'm sure South Pulu is before Khardungla. So I crossed a few patches where I had to go above snow. It was loose snow, a bit of melted snow, and after that I was simply crossing. I was simply going at like what I do not have it recorded, but let me tell you guys, the experience was quite intense. To put it in words, I had no idea that I'll fall. I had no fucking idea that I'll fall. I'd fell earlier as well, as you saw. So I fell earlier as well. That was sort of voluntary, because I did not pay attention to the water flowing. But at this point I had all the attention. I saw the terrain I'm riding towards. It was loose sand with some gravel in it. So I was at I was on the third gear, I guess, and just to slow down I braked, and then I shifted down. The bike just spinned. It just simply spinned on me. I think I was saved because of the fact that I had all the luggage with me, and that took a lot of impact. So it just turned. Luckily, I had this J&K commercial taxi coming beside me. So these guys, they stopped. They picked the bike for me. I hurt my leg, but I was not hurt that much. So I gathered myself up. I made sure everything is fine on the bike. And as usual, it she cranked up on the first self. But I think it was very lucky of me to be riding solo, to be in that situation, and to be very lucky that something hasn't happened to me. If I would have been 10-15 kilometers faster, I'm sure the bike would have gone off the cliff. So it was that close. After that, I rode quite slow. My visor started vibrating, so I shut off one of the side view mirrors and I started riding. This guy met me again at the actual North Kulu spot, and he waved me, and I was like thankful from my heart, man. Thanks a lot. And there onwards, I continued towards Andher. The route again is quite amazing. You will love the whole view, the scenic view of it. I have some of it for you here.
Searching for a longer day. People feeling like the light has just come. We must never stop the way, yeah. Birds chirping and I hear my name. Grasping into a life. Life is happy but it's so insane. We must merely make a start. Savannah, I'm coming home. Savannah, we'll never be alone. Savannah, the beauty of the world. Savannah, let's all take a walk. Savannah. Just begun. We will always take a stand.